The widow of slain Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo is now preparing for the legal battle she will face in connection with the murder of her husband and eight others. We have more from Jose Carretero.
Slain Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo has been laid to rest, but the search for justice is just beginning. Degamo's widow, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, believes the deadly attack that also left eight innocent civilians dead should serve as a wake-up call for the national government.
High time na tutukan talaga yung kaso para hindi naman masayang yung death ng husband ko. His death is an eye-opener to a lot of people from this province as well as sa national, for them to really get a clear picture kung ano talaga ang situation ng peace and order natin dito sa Negros Oriental.
The mayor says she will push for a Senate inquiry not only into her husband's murder but also the series of violent attacks in Negros Oriental.
There has to be investigations done, no? Yun yung I will see to it na makahingi tayo ng tulong sa Senado. Senate inquiry, that has been something na ang tagal na na-request. Sana mapagbigyan na ngayon.
Her family is also thankful many volunteered to help her find justice. Among them are the Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption and the Commission on Human Rights. Mayor Degamo believes it is also now her responsibility to help other victims of violence. At least two victims of other violent incidents have already reached out to her.
Yun yung lumalapit sila sa akin at yun yung sabi ko, sige, pag-usapan natin one of these days, kasi I don't have the facts of the case as well. Sinasabi lang nila, Mayor, ito yung lawyer namin. Mayor, ito yung kaso namin. It is about this ano. So, what's next for us? Parang ganun. So, yung iba, itatanong ko pa nga kung was it Ruel helping them fund the, you know, yung sa mga lawyer na kukunin. Makikiano pa ako. I will have to look at it deeply and see how else can I be of help in my personal capacity.
The mayor notes the legal battle ahead will be tough, but she is confident they have a solid case. Operations in the governor's office at the provincial capital are slowly going back to normal despite some backlogs like the delayed salary of employees.
A status quo order was already issued. So even all the previous designations issued by the late governor has been honored and has been reinstated.
The provincial administrator adds projects and programs of the late governor will be continued. Jose Carretero, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla warns embattled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. his refusal to come home is just putting his innocence under doubt. That, says Remulla, calls Teves' reason for not returning home a poor excuse. The lawmaker, who is abroad, had said he fears for his safety after being tagged in the death of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo and another murder case in the province.
There are no excuses for us. These are poor excuses not to face the charges. And as in the legal maxim say, the axiom is flight is an indication of guilt.
Teves's request for an extension of his leave of absence was denied by the lower house. House Speaker Martin Romualdez has given Teves until March 20 to come home and report for work. But his camp says they will appeal that decision. Meanwhile, a Philippine senator who was once a fugitive is also urging Congressman Teves to return to the country. Padilla says it's better for the lawmaker to come home and face the charges against him.
Alam niyo ako, nangyari din sa akin yan sa experience ko. Nung lumabas din yung aking warrant of arrest, nagtatakot din ako ng isa't kalahating buwan. Umakyat pa nga ako ng bundok bago ko na-realize na kailangan kong harapin kung ano man yung kaso.
Senator Padilla was sentenced to a maximum of 8 years in jail for illegal possession of firearms in 1994 before being granted a presidential pardon. We have this just in: a complaint of illegal possession of firearms, ammunition, and explosives against Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. has been junked. That's according to Department of Justice spokesperson Mico Clavano. Tevez was charged following a police raid of several of his homes in Negros Oriental. This is a developing story and we'll be bringing you more details in our succeeding newscasts. A Philippine drug war victim is cleared of direct assault for allegedly shooting at police officers in an anti-narcotics raid from 7 years ago. A March 3 ruling by a Quezon City court acquitted Efren Morillo for lack of evidence. The decision released on Friday said there was no proof that Morillo fired at the police officers during a by-bus raid in the Payatas area. Morillo lived to belie the police's claim of resisting arrest by playing dead after he was shot in the chest. His four companions were all killed in the raid. The court said a police officer who testified had denied of one of the cops Morillo allegedly shot at was in the area at the time of the operation. It also said prosecutors failed to prove that Morillo owned the firearm he allegedly used. The rare survivor of the drug campaign that has seen thousands killed welcomed the court's ruling.
Mr. Morillo's acquittal in this case is a beacon of light for those whose hopes have been dimmed and distorted by the quote-unquote manlaban narrative. So this decision is proof that in the end, truth will still prevail.
The Philippine Bureau of Investigation issues an apology to members of the media who were allegedly harassed by NBI operatives. The operatives arrested two Chinese nationals for illegal drug possession in Pasay City at dawn Friday. The reporters present were asked to sign the inventory of the seized illegal substances as part of the procedure in a drug bust, but the reporters refused to sign the documents, saying they only arrived at the scene after the operation and not during. Irate NBI personnel confronted the reporters, even grabbing and taking a picture of one media person's ID while calling another a homophobic slur. In a press statement, the NBI apologized for their team's conduct. The agency vowed to probe the matter. Justice Secretary Remulla, for his part, asserts reporters should cooperate with authorities, but only if they covered the whole operation.
So, simulat sa pool dapat, you're part of the cooperative witness already sa simula pa lang ng operation. They have no, you have no duty to testify if you were not really part of it. Dapat yung totoo lang, yun ang gagawin nyo. Kaya most of the time, isasama kayo sa proseso.